Welcome to August Lico Challenge. Today's problem is palindrome partitioning 2. Given a string S, partition S such that every substring of the partition is a palindrome. Return the minimum cuts needed for a palindrome partitioning of S. If we're given the string AAB, our answer is going to be 1 because we can partition it right here between AA and B. That's going to make sure that this is a palindrome, AA, and B is a palindrome. Now if we're given AB, then we can just partition it right in between here. So one of the things we can see is at the very least the minimum number is going to be n minus 1, n being the length of the string. If we just wanted to partition every single character, that would make it technically partitioned palindrome, but we want to find the minimum one, right? So how can we do that? So the very thing we need to figure out first is what are the palindromes inside of our string. Here with like AAB, we can see that other than like AAB itself, we need to figure out what are the other palindromes here. And the only other one is AA, right? So to figure out the palindrome is actually pretty simple. We can do it in n squared time. We can start at the first index and just check every single one that comes to the right to see if it's a palindrome. We can say, all right, is 00 a palindrome? Yes. 01? Yes. What about 02? No, it's not. So what about 11? Yes. 12? No, it's not. And so on and so forth. And we can actually do this even going in out. We can just start at every single character and just move a pointer I minus 1 and then J plus 1, expand our substring all the way to the end to see if it continues to be a palindrome. Now, so what? If we had all the substrings that are palindromes, what can we do with that? Are we going to like have a list? Well, what we could do then is have like a graph traversal. What we'll do is have the starting node or the starting index be the start, and we can have like a set of all the ending indexes that make it a palindrome. So here we know at the very least itself is going to be a palindrome, but we can see with AAB we also know that 0 to 1 is also a palindrome here, right? So then all we need to do is like a depth first search, and what we'll do is traverse from the very beginning. We'll say 0 if it's obviously it counts as itself, so then plus 1 to the next one. So here we'll have 1 also for the next, have like a base case at the end here, this would be nothing. So we'll start at 0, go to 0, that's 1, the next 1, 2, 3, and end here. So that's 3, but we have to subtract 1 because we want to partition it. So that's going to be minus 1, so the answer will be 2 there. But here with like 1, we can go to 0 to 1, that's 1, and then we'll go to 2, and that's 2, and then that'll end. So that'll be like 2 minus 1, and our answer will be 1 here. So you can just kind of imagine like we're traveling from the beginning index to the last index and just trying to see if we can get to the end. And if we can, we want to return one each time and just get the minimum value there that we can calculate. So as we code this out, hopefully this will start making sense. Let's first have a dictionary. This is more like a graph really, but I'm just going to call it default d just to make it a little simpler. We'll say default dict, and this would be a set here. We'll also initialize n. And to get all the palindromes, let's just create a helper method here. What I'll pass in is the I and J. And we'll say, let's see, while I is greater or equal to 0, and J is less than N, and S of I is equal to J or S of J, let's get our default dict. We'll make I the starting, and we'll add to our set the ending point. That is if it's a palindrome, right? Next, we also subtract I and add J here. And that would be it. And all we have to do then is do it for every single character here. So for, let's call it K in range of N. Let's take our helper method and we'll say K, K. And we'll also have to do helper K, K plus 1. And this is going to give us, you know, if you know anything about the palindromes, we have to start either at the middle or we start like with these two in case it's like an odd number, right? Okay, so once we have that, we just need to have our depth first search or some sort of recursive method. So call it depth first search. What we'll do is pass in the index, I'll call it I. So the base case is going to be if I is equal to n, we should return a 0 here. Otherwise, we'll have a temp list. And we are going to traverse all the way to the end. So for, we'll call it J, I guess, in range of I to N. But we also have to have a plus 1 here to get to our base case. If, let's see, if if I in, nope, if I, so if J is in D of I, right, then we want to call our def for search. We're going to append to our temp here def for search, and we'll say I plus 1. And we actually need to add one here to move to the next one, right? Is that right? I'm sorry, I think this might be J. J plus 1 plus 1 here. And at the very end, we just return. This is always going to be populated with at least 1, right? Because J in itself will be in here always. But we want to see if we can get further along. So we'll return the minimum of this. This temp, right? And finally, just return that for search. We start at the very beginning and we're going to subtract 1. One thing we have to do though is make sure to cache, do an LRU cache to use some memoization, because otherwise it's going to do repetitive calls. And this guarantees that it's going to be coming n squared. This will be n squared, this will be n squared, and space complexity will also be n squared. All right, so let's make sure this works. Looks like it's working, so submit it. Oh, and there we go, accepted. Yeah, so this is not very intuitive, but I think the very first thing you can figure out is, okay, we need to figure out all the palindrome values from index to end, the I and J values. And once we get there, I think you start to kind of figure out, oh, okay, I see, we could do this graph traversal here and then get the minimum one. It is a little bit confusing, but I think ultimately, if you can get that first step, the rest can come pretty naturally. All right, so hope that helps. Thanks for watching my channel. Remember, do not trust me, I know nothing.